Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Anaconda in a Windows 11 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Anaconda, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply type Anaconda download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.anaconda.com is basically our first search result. So just click on this individual edition Anaconda, and this will going to redirect you to this official site of Anaconda, and you can clearly see that this is basically the official site of Anaconda. And here you can clearly see that it has rightly recognized that I am using Windows operating system. So if you are using Linux or macOS, then you'll be seeing that these icons is already there for Linux, for Mac, and for Windows, right? So you can, if you are using other operating system, you need to proceed with these links. But since I am going to use it for Windows, and that is Windows 11, this button is rightly given over here. So just simply click on that to basically start downloading our Anaconda, and you can see it has rightly started downloading. So thank you for downloading. Just simply click on the show all, and it has rightly started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see that the latest version of Anaconda, that is Anaconda 3 2021-05, has been rightly downloaded over here. So to install, you need to just simply double click on it. And you can clearly see that our Anaconda installation wizard has been rightly opened over here. So let us first minimize our download directory, and simply click on next. So this is license agreement. Do always read that, and then just simply click on I agree. And now it's asking whether you'd like to install it for just me, which is recommended, or you want to install it for all users. So I'm going to simply proceed with just me, which is also a recommended one. So just keep this default, then just simply click on next. And this is going to be our installation destinations. So they're going to create this Anaconda 3 folder over here. And the important thing is you need to have 2.9 GB of free space in your C drive, since you are installing it in our C drive. So you need to have that much amount of free space in your C drive. Currently I am having 288.4 GB, so it's not a problem. So what I'll be doing is I'll be keep this as a default, and then just simply click on next. And now it's telling that whether you'd like to add Python 3 to my path environment variables, so which is very important, do check that. Right, and then just simply keep this as a default, and then just simply click on install. And you can clearly see that our installation has been rightly begun over here. So this will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after installing our Anaconda. Yeah. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Anaconda has been rightly installed. So just simply click on next. So our Anaconda installation has been rightly completed. Just simply click on next again, and then you have already checked get started with Anaconda individual edition tutorial. Just simply click on finish. And as you can see, it has rightly redirected you to this browser telling that welcome to Anaconda. And here, if you want to watch tutorials, you need to just simply click on this watch tutorial, and you will be getting so many tutorials on Anaconda. So these are all they provide you after installing Anaconda. But now I'm going to show you how you can easily run Hello World program in Anaconda. So you need to just simply click on the search icon, and here you need to just simply type Anaconda, and you can see that our Anaconda Navigator has been rightly over here under app. So just simply click on this Anaconda Navigator, so that we launch our Anaconda Navigator, and from there we'll be opening our Spyder and our Jupyter IDE. So I'm going to show you all of that in this video, so stay tuned with this video. And you can see that our Anaconda is currently launching. And our Anaconda Navigator has been rightly launched over here. So this is basically the interface of our Anaconda Navigator. You can see that it has this Jupyter Notebook, and then it has also this Spyder, right? So it is already installed. So these two IDE, Jupyter and Spyder, are the most popular IDE that we use in our machine learning project. So I'm going to show you both. So first I'm going to show you Jupyter Notebook. So just, you know, simply click on launch, and you can see it is telling that it's launching our notebook. So it will, you know, going to launch in a while, and you can see in our browser it has redirected you automatically, and our Jupyter Notebook has been directly opened over here. So we need to open a new tab. So just simply click on new, then Python 3, so that we open our new Python 3 notebook. So you can see that our new Jupyter Python 3 shell notebook has been directly opened over here. In here, in the first shell, if we just simply type print, then hello world. So hello world. And if you just simply click on this run button, you can see that hello world has been rightly shown in our console. So our Python is working properly. So our Python 3 shell in our Jupyter notebook is currently working, right, with no errors. So so in this way you can easily install Anaconda, and you can easily use Jupyter, so you can do all machine learning related project over here, right? So if you need more videos on that, then please do drop a comment over there in our comment sections basically. Now I'm going to show you how to use the Spyder. So come back to our Anaconda Navigator, and here you can see that our Spyder icon over here, and the version is 4.2.5. So to launch our Spyder, you need to just simply click on this launch button, and you can see that it is currently launching our Spyder. So our Spyder is currently launching, and you can see that our Spyder has been rightly launched over here. So welcome to Spyder. So it's currently giving you some tips and tricks. So I don't want to, you know, make this video long by showing you all this. So I'll just simply click on dismiss, and you can see it is currently connecting to our kernel. So our Python 3 is going to be connected, and you can see it has, you know, rightly connected over here with our Python 3.8.8, right? So this is basically our coding area. So here you can see it has already created this temp.py file, so where you can easily write your code, and you can just simply save it. I'm going to show you all of that, right? And here this is basically our toolbar. So here they have this run button, then run current shell. So if you want to run just single shell, you need to just simply click on that button, right? Similarly, you have so many options. You can debug also, right? So I'm going to, you know, first show you how to run a simple Python program. So let's say we want to print hello world, like what we did in our Jupyter notebook. So print hello world, and now you need to just simply go to file, then save as, right? And now it's telling that Spyder 5.1.5 is available. So if you want to upgrade your Spyder, you can always do that, right? So I don't want to upgrade now. I just wanted to show you just how to use Spyder over here. So here you can see that after clicking on the save as, it has rightly opened this save file window. So I'm going to, in our document directory, I'm going to simply create a new folder, underscore workspace. So in our Spyder workspace, I'm naming it as a hello world, right? And then just simply click on save, and you can see that our hello world.py has been actually saved over here with our simple hello world program, right? And now if you just simply click on this run button, now it will, you know, going to ask you that whether you'd like to execute in our current console. So I am totally okay with it, and then just simply click on run, and you can see that our hello world has been rightly shown in our console, right? So in this way you can easily install Spyder notebook along with your Jupyter as well using our Anaconda Navigator, right? So I have already shown you about PyCharm, and then Intel IJ IDEA as well in my previous videos. So if you are a Java developer, or if you are just Python developer where you are doing some cool projects in Python, then you can use this PyCharm IDE. And if you are a Java developer, then you can use this IntelliJ IDEA IDE as well. Right. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and so please to share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.